Hello, I would like to show you a little bit about how to set up your gradebook. It's very important to have a well-organized gradebook, especially when you teach online, because students need access to a transparent grading system, and the gradebook is the best way to do that. It takes a little patience, but it's definitely worth it. All right, so let's get to work. This is a practice course. It's blank. We start from scratch. And let's click on this gear icon on the top right corner of your window. This will open some options. We need to go to Gradebook Setup. So please click on Gradebook Setup. So this is the blank setup page before any work is done. The first thing is to start adding categories. Categories are normally homework, participation, quizzes, final exam. But of course, every instructor will have different preferences. I'm going to do a basic setup where I have participation being worth 20%. Then I will have homework that is going to be worth 30%. Quizzes are also going to be 30%, and the final exam is going to be 20% of the total grade for the course. This is just an example, but I hope it's going to help you have a big picture of how this works. Okay, so let's start with the first category. We need to click on this button, Add Category. We are going to call this Participation. Aggregation is the first aspect that is going to be very important because one of the greatest challenges of a gradebook is the correct calculation of the grades. If you set this up correctly, it will help you very much. If you don't, it will cause some problems. So let's try to do it this well. Aggregation. All right, so natural means simply that it's going to sum the grades. So if you have, I don't know, five assignments, each one of them is 100, then you're going to have a total of 500 in this category aggregation. A mean of grades, like the word says, is that you're going to have the average. It's going to calculate the average of your grades. And this works, and this is what you need if all your assignments in this category are going to be worth the same. Then you have weighted mean of grades and simple weighted mean of grades. The difference between the two is that simple weighted mean of grades has a calculation based on the maximum grade. So the maximum grade that you assign to an item is going to be the value, the relative value of that assignment. So, for example, if you say that one assignment is worth the maximum grade of one assignment is 20, and the maximum grade of one assignment is 10, then the assignment that has a maximum grade 10 will be worth half of the item that is as a maximum grade of 20. Okay, so that's going to be also the weight. Instead, when you have a weighted mean of grades, you simply have two separate aspects. One is the maximum grade and one is the weight that you are going to assign. In categories that don't have extra credit, weighted mean of grades is probably the best. But in the eventuality of extra credit being included in a category, simple weighted mean of grades is what you need. All right. Let's do it differently for every category so that you have more examples of each. Let's say that we are working on participation here. So in participation, you might have things that are worth different values, and also you might have extra credit. So what would you want here is simple weighted mean of grades. And then I will show you what happens. You can keep it like this for the rest. You don't need to change anything else, and simply click on Save Changes. Now, you have this folder for the course. You see it's called Pieri IT 1150 Practice. And then you notice the indentation and another folder for participation. So this means this is a subcategory under the big umbrella of the course. And this is what we want. All right, so we were saying that we're working on participation. Let's start adding a grade item to participation. I don't know how you want to do this. It all depends, but let's do a participation one, just for simplicity. Let's call it participation one. And we decided that the way that this category is going to be calculated is simple weighted mean of grades. So this means that the maximum grade that you're going to give to this specific item is the weight of it. So we can leave it to 100. Because this is one of our basic grades. And then we will see what we can do for others. All right, so a maximum grade, minimum grade, that's correct. And very important is to select the correct grade category, because if you leave it to the course, this grade is going to go under the big umbrella of the course, straight into the course. Instead, we want it to go under participation. So please select participation and save changes. Okay, so we can do it again if you want. Also, when you have many of these items, you can consider duplicating. You see that if you click on edit, you have an option that is called duplicate. If you click on it, you see that it creates a copy of this participation one. And then when you go to editing, you can change the name and leave the other settings the same. You see, when you click on edit, edit settings, you can call it participation 2, and you notice how the other settings are the same that we used for participation 1. And we can save changes. And we can keep going like this, okay? So let's say that inside participation, you have extra credit. Let's add a grade item. Let's call it extra credit. Well, of course, you can call it whatever you like. And you remember I told you the value of an item when you are using a simple weighted mean of grades is the maximum grade. So if you want this extra credit, for example, to be worth 10%, you give it a maximum grade of 10. And so on and so forth. Of course, if you want it to be less, more, you just change the number. You remember that the other items were worth 100, so relatively to that, this is going to be just 10. And then you first need to select a category, because you see, if you don't, this checkbox is not usable. So please select the category of participation, and then you can click on this box and check it for extra credit. So now let me show you what it will look like with save changes. You see that we have these two first items being worth the same, and then an extra credit is worth 10. And you have on the side this plus and minus, which is the symbol that represents the extra credit. So this is something that students may have or not. It's not going to affect the total, okay? So in fact, you see you have a participation total of 100, and that's very clear and simple for the students to interpret. Let's see another situation, maybe even simpler than this. Let's do homework. Let's click on Add Category. And we call it homework. Let's pretend that all of our assignments are worth the same. So in this case, you choose mean of grades, and this is very simple. Mean of grades, and then this is the other thing that's very important, is to select the parent category. You see, this is just a new category under the whole course, and then, so this is correct, and save changes. Okay, so you see, now under this big frame of the course, you have these two categories, participation and homework. Every time you add an item, a grade, an assignment, they are going to all be worth the same because you selected mean of grades. And you see that you also have this reminder here. So if you want to do this manually, you can do add grade item, call it assignment 1, that you see maximum grade 100, that doesn't matter, and you place it under homework, all right, and save changes. Okay. And then you keep going. You can, if you want, you can duplicate like we did before, you remember, and keep going. So this, when you create these items, keep in mind that these are going to be items that you're going to be grading manually inside the gradebook. There is another way that is maybe even more common to add items to your gradebook, which is creating an assignment on Moodle instead of an outside source, and linking this assignment to your gradebook in the proper category. That's very simple to do. I will show you how to do that in another video. All right. All right. So let's do now a new category, and we will call it quizzes. In a situation like quizzes, you might have extra credit or not. So let's do that you don't have extra credit for quizzes. In that case, you're going to choose mean of grades, because you're going to have a certain number of quizzes and they are all going to be worth the same. Just click on Save Changes. And that's it. You see, you have a third category for quizzes. And then when you add a grade item, you call it quiz one. And you place it under the grade category of quizzes. That's it. Save changes. And you can keep going. Let's just, I will copy just to make it faster. Duplicate. Let's say that I have three quizzes and then duplicate again. So this way you see that the settings are going to be the same. And it's very simple to just change the names to quiz two. And quiz three. Okay, so you see now I have my quizzes and they're all worth the same. The total is going to be based on 100. Then let's do one last thing, the final exam. Let's add another category. Let's call it final. And in the final, you are likely going to have assignments that are weighted differently. So let's use this for an example of weighted mean of grades. And that's all we need to do for now. Save changes. And here we want to have one grade item that is called, let's say, ribbon. Okay. And then you remember we are using weighted mean of grades. So here you can give it a weight. So let's click on weight adjusted and assign it a grade. So in this example, let's do that the written exam is worth 80% and the oral exam is worth 20. So let's do just 8. We can do just 8 or 80 if you want, it's the same. And remember that this is for the final, so we need to select the grade category of final. Save changes. Okay. And then let's do another grade item. And let's call it oral. Okay. Let's adjust the weight to 20 or 2. Let's put it under final and save changes. Okay, I don't know why, well, it doesn't matter, we can change it manually. So you see again, we have a box here, this is the weight. See weights. So let's do 8 and 2. So written 80 and oral 20. Let's save changes. And this is their value. Okay, so this is the difference between having simple weighted mean of grades, where the maximum grade is the weight, and having weighted mean of grades, like here, where you assign a weight and that's separate from the maximum grade. All right, so we are, let's say, all set here. We have participation, homework, quizzes, and final. But you notice that the course total amounts to 400, and this is not convenient. So this means that we need to, as you can imagine, change the settings of the course calculation total because it's probably set up to natural. So you see that we go to the very top where you have the big umbrella of the course and click on edit, then edit settings. And in fact, you notice how here the aggregation is natural. And you remember I told you it means that it just adds up all the grades, all the values to a total, and that's not very clear to read. So since we want our participation to be worth 20%, assignment homework to be worth 30, quizzes to be worth 30, and the final to be worth 20, and so we have different weights, we can decide between weighted mean of grades and simple weighted mean of grades. So remember that the difference is that if you want to have extra credit under a category, choose simple weighted mean of grades. If you don't expect to have extra credit, then choose weighted mean of grades. It happens, it is kind of likely that your extra credit might be applied to the whole course instead of just one category, so you want to choose a simple weighted mean of grades. For just to do something different, let's do weighted mean of grades and save changes. Okay, so now you see that our course total is not 400 anymore, but it's 100. But we have to adjust the weights. You see, these are the weights for the various categories. We said that we want participation to be worth 20, homework to be worth 30, quizzes to be worth 30, and final to be worth 20. So you can write 0.3, 3, 30, whatever you like, as long as the proportion is correct, and then click on Save Changes. Okay? So this way, you are going to have these categories weighting differently, depending on your preference, then the course total of 100, and Moodle Gradebook will calculate your course total always as you go. Okay, so this is wonderful both for you and for your students to know how they are doing in your class. This is a question that we often get: how am I doing in your class? And you can simply say, check your gradebook and you will find out. Okay, in my next video I will show you how to manage your grades and how to manually insert them or otherwise. And I hope this is going to become really useful for you. Thank you so much and goodbye.